Where is he? Where's Roy?
He lives, but without a life. He lives in a closet, an antisocial loner with a love of gadgets.
I wasn't writing about you.
Society doesn't notice him because he's invisible, normal, and ordinary.
You're not ordinary. You're gifted, intelligent, and...
And you're just trying to butter me up.
Look, if you're angry at what I wrote, let's talk, but leave Roy out of it.
Did you come alone?
No backup.
Good. Chapter 6. You have 90 seconds.
No, please!
How do you raise an attack dog? The answer is right in front of you.
I'm looking for anything about my brother.
Hey, you heard that lady on the book cover. Some guy brought this by for you. He said you'd understand.
Chapter 6. You raise an attack dog alone as a puppy. You give it a biscuit. When it bites.
I think I've seen you on TV.
Christian philosophers borrowed from Plato when writing about evil, but Saint Augustine changed this from an objective to a more subjective creation. For instance, Saint Augustine believed that evil was beyond the reach of no man.
So did Freud.
Yeah, well, Freud isn't exactly my favorite moral philosopher. Man's struggle against evil started in the garden and continues unabated because of the fall. Who once said, "Evil is the blemish of our species that will not spare even the best man"? Henry? Anyone? Yes, Kevin.
Kant.
Very good. The 19th century German philosopher Immanuel Kant.
Actually, it's the 18th century. Kant died in 1804, but wrote his major works in the 18th century.
Thank you, Kevin. The devil is in the details. I stand corrected.
You hardly speak up, but when you do, it's worth the wait. You have a first-rate mind, Kevin. But about your thesis, I'm still waiting on that prodigal first draft.
I have hit a wall.
Well? Search along the wall till you find a door.
Hey, genius. Nice call on Kant.
An Another piece of advice. If you're blocked, take a day off. Get out into the fresh air while you still can. Before you end up an old dried up professor like me.
That'd be an honor, sir.
But I do need to see an outline before the end of next week. No shirking. You know what I'm capable of.
Wrath. Hello?
You have 3 minutes to confess your sin before I blow your car up.
Someone must have left this phone in the car. It's not...
Kevin Parson, you can't hide in the seminary. You can't drive away from your past.
Who is this?
Don't you remember me, Kevin?
I'm hanging up.
You're passing into the Harbor Tunnel. Your clock reads 2:57. And you don't remember what to confess. Here's a clue. What falls but never breaks... What breaks but never falls?
What falls? Is this a joke?
Don't believe and die.
Hello?
Kevin, you remember everything. Liar. Liar. Liar.
You know, I thought he had the wrong person. Then he said my name.
Mm-hmm.
What falls but never breaks? What breaks but never falls? What does that mean to you?
What does it mean? Nothing. It's nonsense.
Kevin, we didn't find his cell phone. Maybe it burnt up in the blast.
So he called you some names. Gives you a riddle. Tells you your car's gonna blow. That's it. Nothing else.
You're out of RK, right?
The riddle killer. You must have been living in a box not to have. RK's been making all the press.
And why would someone like this come after me?
Have you done anything to, call attention to yourself? Made any enemies?
Who is he?
It's Kevin Parson, seminary student.
RK tends to pick on those he perceives as rising up above the herd.
Both parents died in a car accident, raised by his aunt. No siblings.
How does he make a living?
lives off his parents' life insurance. He has a BS in engineering, an MA in English Lit, and he's working on his PhD in theology.
A professional student.
Yeah.
Books.
You read them all? Books.
Not yet.
So I got something for you here. Here we are. It's my alarm beeper.
Just press the button and we'll come running. And it also has a tracking device on it. It's a pretty cool toy.
Come on. Get out. So keep it on you. And don't worry, there's never been a second attack.
Well, technically, no one's ever survived the first attack.
Is that the car explosion that happened earlier today is linked to the Commerce Street explosion that killed Roy Peters, the brother of noted police profiler Dr. Jennifer Peters. Now the police are currently speaking with the owner of the vehicle, Kevin Parsons. But we don't believe he was injured.
Kevin, did you tell the police everything, or did you leave out the best parts? No police! Or I may tell them what you did.
Who are you?
Who are you, Kevin? Are you still the lonely boy in a blue house, taking comfort from your pain with a black puppy? Don't answer that. We're not finished yet.
Kevin, it's Sam. I just saw the news. I want to make sure you're okay.
I'm gonna come over.
Sam! Sam!
You swore that you would never go back there.
Why are you doing this?
Would you go back to save Damon? You have 60 minutes to save a life you value. But no police. That's my number one rule.
Damon.
Hi, Kevin.
Hey, Bobby.
I have a new computer. You want to see it?
Well, that's really cool, man. Hey, I'm going to go say hi to Damon, okay?
Damon misses you. Where'd you go?
Shut the door!
And don't talk to strangers.
It's Kevin. He came back home.
That's not Kevin, Pumpkin. That's a stranger.
Look, Belinda, I just came to check on Damon. Then I'm going to get out of here.
Oh, you turned running away into an art form, huh?
Damon. Hey, buddy. You okay?
Hey.
Kevin! Kevin, is that you, old boy?
Hey, Eugene.
Kevin, where you been? Huh?
Damon! Do not play with strangers! It's poison!
Eugene! Just don't stand there! Control your animal! If you don't, I will.
Damon, back in your house.
You have to growl at that dog. You have to use more authority, more discipline.
Boy, say there, canine, till he can't with you. It should be the whip for your blasted hoy.
Firmer!
Come here, beast.
More English.
Stay. Stay, I say.
No. Put him in the house.
Very good. Kevin, I have a new computer. You want to see it?
Stay!
It's a brand new computer. Princess gave it to me. You want to see it? It's so great. I can play with it up to 10 o'clock at night. And then
but
I really love to play.
No. You wait.
David!
What did they do?
Why didn't you?
Where's David?
I know him. It was you.
You did this! Why?
Why, to hurt me again, huh?
No. Someone's trying to kill me.
Shut your lying, filthy mouth. We hate you.
That's right, traitor. You go! Go! Leave! Leave!
Who's there? Sam. Missed you.
You look good.
So do you.
There's some dirt on your face.
I love this place. You okay?
I don't know. You know, you shouldn't be here.
Well, of course I should.
No, Sam, someone's stalking me.
I'm not leaving.
They blew up my car. They killed Damon. I just don't want you near this.
Look, I'm near criminals every single day.
I know. You know, I got a cop right across the street.
Yeah, he's asleep.
I have no idea what he meant.
What falls but never breaks. What breaks but never falls. Night falls and day breaks. The answer could be day and night.
Meaning what, though?
I don't know yet. I'm gonna take this and give it to a friend at the lab.
Take it.
Do you have a bag or something?
Yeah, probably in the kitchen.
I should probably check into a motel.
Just stay here. I mean, you know what I mean. I'll stay on the couch. It's okay?
Yeah. I'm gonna need your spoon so I can get a control sample and exclude your prints. Staying here probably wouldn't be the best idea.
Why?
Probably stay up talking all night and you need to rest.
Hey, we can't talk to the police.
Okay, but we might have to.
I just don't want you to get hurt.
Kevin? Hi, Kevin.
Hi, Sam.
Let's go.
I can't. Belinda won't let me.
So?
I can't.
Why not? We could take the bus together.
I know, but my mom likes teaching me.
She's not your mom. She's your aunt.
So, do you have a boyfriend at school?
I have a boyfriend, but he doesn't go to my school.
Who is he?
It's a secret. He's my knight in shining armor. Come closer and I'll tell you.
Did you get from those things which you are now ashamed? For the end of those things is death.
What's going on? What's going on?
We're trying to get in the club.
Go home.
I don't know.
Are you, hey, you guys are 15. Right.
Hey, sorry. Parson, I want to ask you a question about the Riddle Killer. I understand you've been talking to him.
Get a real job.
I got a real job. And that's private property.
Yeah, well, this could trigger a repeat attack. We need to talk. Hope you take it with milk.
Hey!
Sorry about your brother.
You look like you've been up all night.
I have been.
Is this the only way in and out?
There's a fire escape close to your brother?
Yeah. Who was the visitor?
Someone I grew up with. Samantha Shear. She saw what happened to me in the news. She's an insurance investigator.
What, and she came by to check your life insurance?
She's a friend.
Anyone else?
He was in here. He left a cell phone and a book.
What did he say?
Nothing. He just called me names again.
Well, show me the cell.
It's gone. I think he came back in here and took it.
Well, can you show me the book?
Sam has it.
Do you know who we're dealing with? Three people have died. I need that book. So call your friend. And from now on, make sure I see everything first.
Okay.
You ever play chess?
What does that have to do with any of this?
He made a move, and you countered, and he liked it. He'll move again.
Great.
He'll be watching and listening to everything.
What, you mean like now?
Shh!
He said no police. You're a cop. He said no police. You're a cop.
Kevin always was a nasty little tattletale.
Help me. Help me. Please help me. Help me.
I need to get this together right away.
He said I'd be here at 9. I don't want to die. Get it off me. Please.
Two questions. How did he choose you? And why did he choose you?
How did he choose your brother?
Oh, Roy was a means of getting at me. I wrote a book he didn't find very authentic. He didn't like me going on talk shows, promoting it. Anyway. Yeah, maybe I did get a little too full of myself. Pride comes before a fall.
Writing a book is no sin.
Well, neither is going to a seminary. So let's start yesterday and work back. As far as you can. Every place you ever went.
You want to hear my whole life story?
Oh, I have a full tank.
I won't take a full tank.
A guy just walked into precinct headquarters with a bomb strapped on him.
The wages of sin.
What?
The wages of sin.
He left a message. The wages of sin.
The wages of sin is...
death.
It's a Bible verse. Your stalker doesn't like seminary students. He went after one of your classmates, Henry Jameson.
Henry? Oh.
Give me the book and verse number.
It's from Romans.
Look in Romans.
Where's the bomb squad?
They won't make it in time.
Maybe we should just move them.
What?
Keep it clear.
Wait here.
Let's go. Okay, now.
Okay. Okay, here it is, right here. Romans 6:23. Wages of sin. Okay.
Help me! Help me!
What benefit did you get from this? things which you are now ashamed. For the end of those things is death.
Help me!
What's the third number? We need a third number.
Okay, there's six letters in Romans. Let's try 6623.
Get out! Everybody out!
What are you doing here? Get out!
Out! Everybody out! Clear the building!
Your stalker went after someone else?
Hurry.
What happened?
It's my fault if he died.
You can't blame yourself for this.
You don't know.
Six.
Six.
Get it off him!
Hey, you! And you! Out! Now! Go!
Get
okay,
off.
Let's go. Let's go.
23.
Hurry! Please!
Go, go. Kids and used to sneak out together.
Yeah, okay. I remember.
Sometimes I'd see this boy. He liked watching us.
Kevin, I don't know what you're...
At your window. I told you about him. I remember one night. I caught him at your window. He was looking at you, watching you.
Anybody about me?
I won't.
And I'll kill you next time.
Well, thank goodness you did. My dad chased him away. He didn't live in our neighborhood.
My dad won't let me out.
Never saw him again.
I saw him again.
But you never told me.
I never told anyone.
Run! Tattletale! You're gonna die! Run! Run, you little moron! Run!
He chased me into this old warehouse.
No!
Thanks for bringing us down here.
No!
Go ahead. Scream!
No one's gonna hear you down here, snitch. You know what I'm gonna make you do? You're gonna bite off your own tongue. Puke!
Bite it!
Tattletale! Then I'm gonna visit your stuck-up girlfriend.
I'm gonna kill both of you!
I stood there, thinking if he got out, he might hurt you.
What'd you do?
I left him to die. Never went back. Never told anyone. That's my sin. I tried to forget it ever happened. Maybe going to the seminary was my act of penitence.
He must have gotten out. Someone would have found his body. We live nearby, it would have been in the news.
He got out. And now he's stalking me.
It's pretty far-fetched to think that after all these years, someone would plan to get even with us for something that happened when we were kids.
He tried to kill Henry. Maybe he set Jennifer up to get her into our game.
We'll forget the game. We're leaving town.
Where?
My place, for starters, and then we'll go from there, okay?
Hey! That's my thesis! Sam, Rick!
No. Kevin, be careful!
That's him!
I'm calling the cops. Stay away from the window.
But we can't!
You can't. I can.
I couldn't really see him.
When you turned around, were his eyes at your eye level?
I didn't see his eyes.
So you don't know if he was tall, short, fat, thin?
No.
Kevin Parson left when we cleared the building.
Well, bring him back.
Calm down with the orders. I never put you on this.
I'm on this.
Phone call for you? Samantha Shearer.
Hello?
Yeah, I'm a friend of Kevin Parsons.
Right. Insurance. Where's Kevin?
We're at his place. We may have just seen a stalker at his window. He had a camera. He was taking pictures of Kevin.
Josh, send units to cordon off a 20-block grid centered on Short and Vine. Look for a guy with a camera. Listen to me, it's not safe. I want you and Kevin out of there. I want you back here now.
It's all right, I'm armed.
I don't care if you're armed or not. This isn't an insurance claim. I want you and Kevin out. That's an order.
Okay, I hear you. Hang on.
Let me out. Why did you leave me, Kevin?
Let me out of here.
Let me out.
TV just went off in Kevin's refrigerator.
Oh, wait, let me hear him.
Quick, record
this. Let me out. It's so dark in here. Let me out. The cockroach has not confessed his sin. So we must play on to the end. The trigger is pulled. The trigger is pulled. Only 30 minutes tick before the to and fro drones are blown to bits.
Confess what sin?
What takes you there but takes you nowhere, Kevin. And remember, no cops.
Get down!
Send emergency response to Parsons' place.
You got it.
He seems to be obsessed with threes. 30 minutes to act, 90 seconds to save Roy.
Kevin Parson,
the seminary student whose car was allegedly destroyed by the Riddle Killer yesterday, is on our action phone live to discuss important matters about the case.
Parsons on TV.
When I was 14, I got into a fight with this boy from our neighborhood. He chased me into this warehouse, and
we fought. I ran out and locked him in.
I left him to die. I'm a fake and a hypocrite.
What's he doing?
He's confessing.
I'm a sinner.
He's listening. I just want to say I'm sorry. I'm so sorry.
Poor Kevin.
Samantha Shearer calling back on line one. Put Kevin on.
Look, he's pretty upset. He thinks the killer's this kid who used to bully us.
Yeah, I heard. Can you give me a name?
I don't know. Kevin locked him in a storage warehouse.
Where? What's the address?
Off Carmine Street. Look, this kid didn't live in our neighborhood, and he didn't go to our school or anything. We're talking 15 years back, so it's all pretty hazy. My dad, he chased him away. He was a cop. Maybe he left a name in a case file or something.
Your dad's retired?
He died 5 years ago, Sam Shearer.
Send a team to a warehouse on Carmine and check all police reports filed by an officer Sam Shearer dealing with juvie offenders starting 20 years back. Are you and Kevin okay?
Yeah.
Sam. I confessed. It's over.
Kevin, I can't bet on his forgiveness, and he said the trigger is pulled.
No, it's over. Everybody knows what a terrible person I am. It's all he wanted.
Okay. It's over. But let me ask you something. When he said, what takes you there but takes you nowhere, what does that mean to you?
What takes you there but takes you nowhere? I have no idea.
A bus. All they do is go back and forth. There and nowhere.
The bus that went by our old neighborhood was number 33.
They think he might hit bus 33.
There are three number 33 buses running simultaneously on a 12-mile route.
So we clear all three.
No, black and white will pull him over.
No, he said no cops, at least not in uniform, or he might blow before the deadline.
Hey, how you doing?
Not so good. Can't complain.
Come on, everybody out.
What did the boy look like? Can you remember any characteristics, like a scar or a tattoo?
He bragged about being in juvenile detention.
Juvenile records are often wiped clean, but it's worth a shot.
Well, that narrows it down to a couple of thousand suspects. Where are you?
We're looking for the bus.
Stop. Sam, that was the Third Avenue bus.
The three on your refrigerator.
Said no cops.
Hey, I didn't call the cops.
Samantha did.
break the rules, I break my word.
No, no, I confessed. That's what you wanted, isn't it?
You confessed nothing.
What?
Everybody's off!
Cover your ears, puke.
Sam! Sam!
I promise.
My dad's stuff's in storage. There's got to be something on this guy. I'm gonna go there. You get a ride home with Jennifer, okay?
Talk to me.
Sam talked to you and he blew it early.
You should have told me about the kid.
Because I can't help you if I'm playing catch-up.
Just don't help me. Just don't.
He's here. I know he is.
What do I do?
I want you to walk away and meet me in the Grand Hotel bar in 5 minutes.
Liar.
Kevin Parsons.
Cheater. You confessed nothing.
I shut the door. I left him to die.
Owner
I'm sorry.
Of...
Liar! 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 Liar!
Kevin Parsons.
I left him to
You're
die.
You're the sick one, Kevin.
This is Darla Goodman with the Action Team Live, and behind me is a Redline City bus that was destroyed at close to 3 p.m. today by what the police are now calling a combustible device. Darla, have the police made any statement yet? They're not labeling it a terrorist attack yet, nor are they linking it.
Where's Samantha?
Are you still there?
She went to check out her dad's stuff.
Oh. May I get you something? No, I'm good. Kevin, it's not you. It's him. He's twisted beyond your capacity to understand his sickness. These people enjoy holding life and death authority. Absolute power. Absolute control. If RK is this kid from your past, we will find him. You have to trust me that I won't let him hurt you. So I better get to it.
I'll help you in any way I can.
Then take a drive with me through your old neighborhood. Stop by your aunt's house. See if that jogs your memory.
I can't do that.
Kevin.
I can't.
My name is Jennifer Peters. I'd like to come in and ask you a few questions about your nephew.
Certainly not.
Ma'am, your nephew is in serious danger.
Do you have a search warrant?
Do I need one?
We all make mistakes, dearie.
Belinda, if I get a search warrant,
It'll be the sworn duty of the police to turn you home inside out.
Don't touch anything. Ask your questions.
Do you like to play?
Bobby! Hush!
I have a new computer. It's real. You want to see?
Bobby, go to your room.
She's pretty, Mom.
She's a dog, Bobby. You want to get fleas? That's what you'll get if you play with her. Fleas. Go to your room. Read your books. And sleep. Eugene, don't just sit down. Where are your manners? Get our guest a chair.
Yes, of course, Princess. Your chair, milady.
When was the last time you left this house?
Why would I leave the house?
Do you know who the president is?
Eisenhower.
Eisenhower is the only worthy president. We don't go in for pretenders.
How long have you been doing this?
Doing what?
Oh, you've created your own world in here. Cutting away what you don't like, keeping the rest. What do you do with the clippings? You burn them. Why?
What we do in our home is our business. We're safe here.
What about Kevin? Was he safe here?
Oh, my sister's boy always thought he was too smart for us. Bobby was the poor little dummy. Yeah, Kevin thought he was God's gift, sent to cast light on us poor idiots.
Do you even want to know what kind of trouble he's in?
It all started when he was sneaking out at night with that girl. She's the one that led him astray.
You mean Samantha Shear?
He didn't think I knew. But I knew. She's the one that put those nasty little thoughts in his head by wanting me to send him to the same high school as her.
Instead of you teaching him?
The only way to raise a child is to isolate them with the truth. And they shine like stars.
You let a boy walk out of this house with no idea the real world he'd be facing. It's no wonder he survived it all.
Your time is up.
Someone's been threatening Kevin. Someone who may have known him and bullied him as a teenager. Do you remember anything about that?
He came home one night with a bloody nose and a black eye. That's what's outside. Blood and chaos.
What are you looking for, Jennifer? What will you find? Don't come too close to the lonely boy, Jennifer, or you won't walk away this time.
Went over every one of Sam Shear's written reports at his old precinct. Nothing about a peep in some juvenile. Where are you?
I'm at the warehouse.
You're gonna need a flashlight. Those, old Comment Street warehouses have been closed down for years.
What do you got?
Definitely blood. Give me 8 hours. I'll have a full DNA analysis ready for you.
Blood positive.
Oh, looks like a weapon.
Any skeletons in the closet?
Nope. But we found a bloody jacket. Oh, this backs up Kevin's story. The fight took place. The kid must have crawled out through there.
Search all the rooms. Maybe Kevin killed the kid, hid the body.
There's a group of reporters camped outside Parsons' loft.
Oh, I put him in a hotel to keep him out of the spotlight.
Good. Which one?
Come on, Sam. Naked is safer.
You hide a key witness. You don't bother telling your superior officer about it.
I'm not officially on this case.
Got a thing for him, don't you? The fact of the matter is, you don't even know who Kevin Parson is.
Kevin, it's me, Sam.
Jennifer called. She told me you were here. You're not keeping anything from me?
How can I? You know me better than I know myself.
This isn't a good idea. We've never kept secrets from each other. This isn't a good time to start.
Remember when you told me about your secret boyfriend?
Yeah.
Why didn't we ever become something more?
I went to school and moved away. And you got busy with college.
Thank you.
I'm here now.
I'm so tired.
I know. I want you to be careful around Jennifer Peters.
Why?
Her stalker has all the skills of a cop, and he called me right after I gave her my cell number.
What are you saying? It's not Jennifer.
I'm not saying it is. Trust her. But test me first, okay?
Tonight, I'm going to take everything from you until there is nothing left.
I shut the door. I left him to die.
Tonight, you get to kill for real, Kevin.
Hello?
Samantha, it's Jennifer Peters. How's Kevin?
He's sleeping. I took the adjoining room so I could keep an eye on him.
Okay. I need to talk to Kevin. I'm on my way.
Okay, we'll be here. Hang on, there's someone at the door.
Careful. Nobody knows you're there.
Hello?
Hello?
Let me out.
Samantha?
Why did you leave me, Kevin?
Hello?
Let me out. It's so dark in here. Let me out. It's so dark in here.
You confessed nothing. Tonight I'm going to take everything from you until there is nothing left. The cockroach has not confessed his sin. So it's time to play the riddle game again.
I confessed!
There are sins Kevin thinks he would never do. Fears waiting to come true. Confess the rest, Kevin!
Smart to figure it out. We don't break his rules.
What wants to be filled but will always be empty? The city fathers gave it a number. 36933.
You followed me?
Yeah, well, I wouldn't have to if you weren't sneaking around, operating behind my back. Where's Parson?
He just left with Samantha Shear.
What do you got?
Another message with a timed riddle and a threat of body parts.
Time to play. You have 1 hour. What wants to be filled but will always be empty? The city fathers gave it a number. 36933.
Storage warehouse. How did you know that?
I told you I put my dad's stuff in storage. It's the place. I have an access key.
He knew that. We shouldn't be here.
You sure you don't know what else he wants you to confess?
What could be worse than what I did?
Sam, there's no reason for us to go into this building. Look, this is going to blow any minute.
We didn't break his cop rule, so we should have 17 minutes. If we don't figure this out, other people are going to die. Wait here, I'll be back, okay?
No, you're not going in there by yourself. It's a bad idea. This feels wrong.
I better get my cell.
I got it. Sam?
Kevin! Hey!
I need the flashlight! Give me the light!
Kevin! What are you doing?
Up here! Here, Sam!
Kevin, listen to me. You have to get out of here. Kevin!
These are all lines from your thesis. It's pretty dark stuff. Pay money to study this? Radical evil is a deep blemish of our species.
He didn't find it very original. I didn't write this.
You mean your house is afire?
It's not mine.
Wait, what's this? He's not done with us yet. Your house is afire. How many places have you lived?
Just my loft.
In your aunt's place.
Linda won't let you in. She might not even let me in.
You get this look every time you talk about her.
What look?
That look.
She just tried to get me to see things the way she sees things.
Midnight. We have 2 hours. I'm gonna take a cab to your loft. You take my car to Belinda's place and call me. I can see that. Why didn't you answer your phone?
Because he said no cops.
You know, you have to trust me.
He left another riddle.
Okay. Where? What's the timeline? Do you see this? I quit. I quit. I swear to you, I'm never setting foot in the station again, okay? I'm done. I'm no longer a cop. I'm not a cop. I'm Roy's sister.
Go read the wall.
Princess.
Kevin! It's Uncle Eugene! They stole Princess!
Princess? Where's Princess? Where's Princess? Hiding like a roach in the dark.
she's gone.
What?
She never leaves home without telling me. You have to find her.
Where's Bobby?
Inside.
I gotta get you guys out of here.
Why?
Because the house isn't safe.
Princess.
Bobby? Bobby!
Captain, can you help me find Princess? She's hiding.
Okay.
At first, I thought the princess went out to get dog food, and then I remembered we burned the dog.
I need you to go with Eugene to the gas and go. Buy some cookies and pop, and when Princess gets back, we'll have a big party, okay? Okay, can you do that for me?
Okay.
Okay, come on.
Kevin, I have a new computer. You want to see it?
That's really awesome. I really need you to do this for me right now, okay? You stay there till I come for you.
Come on, Bobby. Come on. Come on, Bobby. Come on.
Who are you, Kevin?
No. Liar!
Are you still the lonely boy in a blue house?
Liar.
Confess the rest, Kevin.
You're a liar!
Where there's light, there's shadow.
I'm looking for a Kevin Parsons.
Kevin, it's Dr. Francis. I was worried and I was calling to see if you're okay. If you need to talk.
You left this number. This is Phil at the lab. That book on St. Augustine that you had me dust, I was able to pull about 6 dozen prints, but all of them match the control sample. Call me.
Kevin! Kevin, it's Uncle Eugene. They stole Princess. They stole Princess. Bobby is no worry. He just keeps going from room to room calling for Princess, Princess.
Hey, we got some 38 shell cases over here and some footprints. Looks like a struggle.
Parson tell you anything about a shootout?
No. All he said was there was a clue to another bomb riddle somewhere in here.
The guy's playing.
You know, there's something not consistent about all this. With Kevin, the clues tend to be metaphoric opposites, like light and shadow. With Roy and me, R.K. tended to be more like a tour guide. He wasn't into this kind of symbolism.
Maybe he changed his personality with each victim.
Hey, can you back up?
Jennifer, it's Sam.
Where are you?
I'm at Kevin's loft. Listen, I don't think the Riddle Killer is the boy.
I was just thinking the same thing. He could have copycatted R.K.
No. I mean, I don't even think the boy is the boy.
What?
Kevin Stalker only appeared when he was finishing his thesis. It's all about good and evil, light and dark.
Opposites.
So what if Kevin and his stalker are opposites in the same person?
Hey, Mike, how many sets of footprints you got?
It's hard to say, but what I am seeing is one set of distinct tread patterns. A man's tennis shoe size 11 or 12.
But the boy exists.
You saw him.
No. I thought I had, but I realized I never really did. I just thought I did because Kevin talked about him all the time.
But someone left a cassette player outside your hotel room door. Wasn't Kevin with you?
I thought he was sleeping. And the person outside his window could have been a news reporter.
The boy doesn't exist. Kevin's personality split.
I don't know. You're the psychologist. Does this make any sense to you?
When Kevin locked the boy in the basement 15 years ago, he was actually locking away an alter ego in his own head. Then when Kevin's thesis forced him to fully examine the nature of good and evil in himself,
the boy resurfaced.
Like a latent virus, he would have returned and fought back for survival. One personality hating the other, trying to kill the other.
And kill the person who caused the split in the first place.
Belinda's missing.
I'm going there now.
Wait, I'll meet you.
Okay, but no screaming cop cars or...
I know. Kevin might kill himself.
Hello, Kevin. Put down the gun.
Who are you? Put down the gun. Let her go. Put it down now!
Let her go!
Put it down! Put down the gun or I blow her head off!
we've been expecting you. I don't think we've been officially introduced. You can call me Slater. Welcome to my house. Or I should say, our house. You know, Kevin, they think you're crazy as a loon. They think you're me, the riddle killer. Tomorrow in the headlines, it's going to say, your mommy, dearest, drove you to kill her.
Shut up, Ralph! Staple your lips together!
I'm here. My car's parked outside. I'm gonna go in.
Look, I'm 5 minutes behind you. Can you keep your phone on?
Yeah, I'll try. The house is dark. I don't see anyone. Wait. Where the worms hide their secrets.
Where the worms hide their secrets? What is that?
I'm at the garden shed. Nothing yet. Wait. The steps go down into a basement.
That's because you're stupid.
I hear voices.
More than one? You mean Kevin and Belinda?
Kevin got himself a gun.
I'm putting you on mute.
Why?
Wait!
You
want
to kill somebody? Is that what you want? You'll never get away with this. You're sick. You're crazy. Huh? You want to taste it? Well, stick out your tongue.
Why are you doing this? I confessed. I told everyone what I did to you.
You confessed nothing! Your pathetic confession revealed nothing!
For tomorrow's headlines, they're going to reveal the true nature of Kevin Parsons. My plan is perfect.
Well, this is your perfect plan?
You're sick.
Yeah.
Oh, I'm the sick one?
You're the sick one, Kevin!
You don't even know how sick you are.
At least I'm not a hypocrite. They think you and I are the same. Well, guess what? Tonight you're gonna prove them right!
Jennifer, I was wrong.
I just saw him. So who do you mean? Kevin?
Yeah, no. Both of them.
He's real.
Kevin Stalker's real.
Who is he?
He's...
Samantha can't talk now.
Samantha. Wake up. Wake up, sleepyhead. Come on. Come on. Just like old times in the neighborhood.
Except this time, Kevin's gonna kill for real.
Never.
Kevin.
And he's gonna take the blame for everything.
You're just sick.
Stick and stones. She calls me sick. He calls me an animal. I'm not a hypocrite sitting in a church pew every Sunday, swearing to God that I'll be good, just like Kevin here, even though he knows he's disgusting. Even though he knows he tried to kill and hide it.
You're worse than me.
Hi, Princess. How you doing? Good? Almost midnight. The cockroach has yet to confess his sin, and so it's time to play out the game to the end.
No!
Get her! Get her! Get there!
You hate her. Look, you've been thinking about it. Come on, take it. Take it! Take it!
Oh, it's his fault. Pain, loneliness, all your torment. You hate her! Take it!
Leave him alone!
Kill her! Kill her now! Do it!
No, Kevin, it's not Belinda you want to kill.
That's right.
Kevin, don't!
Do it. That's right.
Dean! Don't do it, Kevin.
Shoot her!
Oh, true love. How touching.
Don't do it, Kevin, please.
Do it or I'm going to spit roast your true love right in front of you. Do it!
He's gonna kill us all anyway. He has to know witnesses. But he's gonna burn up all traces if you're even here. And you take the fall.
Do it now!
Kevin, don't. He's gonna kill us all anyway! He's gonna kill us all anyway.
Freeze! Freeze! Kevin?
You move and they die.
Are you okay?
Stay back.
Jennifer, listen to Sam.
Shut up! You two are driving me crazy!
Drop the gun, or we all go.
Slater shot Sam.
Kevin, look at me. Kevin, there's no one in here except you, me, and Belinda.
What?
Samantha and Slater aren't real.
Why are you saying that?
She must have a plan. Go along.
No, Sam. The truth is I don't have a plan. The truth is you were half right. Slater is Kevin. But so are you. He created you both when he was a little boy. Locked in that house. You were created from all the good things he wanted in a friend.
But you saw Sam. At the hotel. And at the police station.
And you! Out! Now!
I never saw Sam. And outside the hotel, it was you in the car. I never actually saw her.
Let's go.
But it's not true. I'm bleeding.
Are you?
Yes?
Yeah, she's real.
And Kevin's bleeding, and he... Wait, why are you bleeding? You didn't get shot.
It's a bunch of psycho crap. Your book is crap. You couldn't even figure out who the real killer was. And he's right in front of you.
Kevin, they're listen real. To me.
It doesn't matter. It's not true. I believe that. I believe they're real.
Time's up. Kill her! Kill her now!
But I confessed. I confessed I locked you in that closet.
You confess nothing!
Go ahead, Kevin. Empty the trash. Do it.
Kill her! Kill her now!
No, Kevin. It's not Belinda you want to kill. It's him. You want to kill the evil inside yourself.
Do it!
The sin is that you're him. What falls but never breaks, what breaks but never falls, and I can say it's you.
She's the one that locked you in the room. She filled your head with a bunch of trash.
Kevin, he can't pull the trigger unless you do.
Shut up!
Kevin, in your thesis, you wrote about the three natures of every human being. The good, the bad,
and the soul struggling in between.
I'll kill you all!
You also wrote that we're powerless to win the struggle on our own. We could take the bus together. I love you.
Me too.
hope you lock him up and throw away the key.
Let's get out of here.
Kevin studied the Riddle Killer. He copied his techniques.
He's right in front of you.
He's holding a camera.
Yeah, we shouldn't have noticed someone taking photos of the crime scene.
I was looking for anything about my brother.
Hey, you're that lady in the book cover. Some guy left this by for you.
Roy!
Go, 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 go!
Free! Free!
Don't move! Hang on, I can see him! Come in!
Free!
Keep your hands where they are.
Clean up pretty nicely. I see they got all the bits of Roy off.
You took pictures of Kevin Parson. Why?
I intended to pay him a little visit. I can't stand copycats.
Get him out of here.
You got it.
Get him out of here. That's it.
Another couple of hours and we would have caught on that Sam Shear never had a daughter. Kevin rented Samantha's car. There's so many holes he couldn't have kept plugged.
And since it was Slater who caused the bus explosion, not Kevin, will the court take that into consideration?
I hope. A place like this is better than prison.
How long will he be here?
It's up to the courts to decide.
The person that caused it all got scot-free.
Belinda.
Kevin grew up in a world of shifting realities. No absolutes. He created good and evil.
Samantha and Slater.
It's a battle we all have to struggle with. It's a battle we're powerless to win on our own.
And we need the power of a Samantha?
We need the power of God.
Talk to you later, Sam. Just kidding. I'm good. Good.
money, gotta change the way I am. Save me like a precious mother. Kill me like a vicious brother. Kiss me like there is no other. Show me that you care.